I can't imagine what it must be like to have cancer. It has to be terrible. What it does to your body, and then even the treatment itself. How miserable that must be to go through, the lack of appetite, the weakness, the loss of hair, and so many other things. But I have often wondered if what is more difficult when it comes to cancer and other terminal illnesses is the thought of death. Especially when you get such an illness, maybe decades before you thought you were going to die, and now all of a sudden have to be faced with the thought of death. It can be troubling, even for the strongest of Christians, as we ask that question, why? Why now, God? Why? The Apostle Paul had an incredible perspective on life and death, especially he who faced imprisonment, even faced martyrdom. Yet he said these words in Philippians chapter 1, verse 21 and following. Yes, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. But if I am to go on living in the flesh, that will mean fruitful labor for me. Yet which should I prefer? I do not know. I'm pulled in two directions, because I have the desire to depart and be with Christ, which is better by far. But it is more necessary for your sake that I remain in the flesh. See, the Apostle Paul knew that heaven would be far better. To die would be far better for him because he would be with the Lord forever in heaven. But even if God had desired for him to remain in life, you know, even then he could be content and happy because, as he said, to live is Christ, to die is gain. And so whether he lived or whether he died, he wanted to dedicate his life to the Lord who loved him and had given him the certain hope of everlasting life. What an awesome perspective when it comes to life and death. Whether we have a terminal illness or whether we're completely healthy, to remember this truth, to live is Christ, to die is gain. Yes, it is a win-win for us. Whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. So no matter what we face, may we desire to serve the Lord with our lives until that day when he takes us home to be with him forever in heaven. Amen.